I'm Sushma Hegde and I'm here today to show you how we can make this stamped floral card a lot colorful with watercolors. For this, you'll need a watercolor paper, and I've stamped the flowers on a watercolor paper here, and a small brush, a size 2 or a size 4 brush, and any watercolor of your choice. We start by taking clean water in our brush and gently applying it throughout the flower that we're going to paint. And then we take some color. Here I'm mixing pink with a little bit of yellow to get a nice reddish orangish color. And as the flower is still wet with water, I just add the color. I just dab, make little dabs of it at the ends of the flower petals. You can see it's slowly starting to spread because of the water we added earlier. Now I'm just taking a little darker version of it. I'm taking the darker pink and just adding little dots at the end so that that blends in along with this orange as well. Let me help that paint to flow in a little bit. So I just dried my brush to the kitchen towel and gently push it inwards. We don't want spots of color here and there. We want it to look seamless and very nicely blending within the flower. I'll clean my brush with clean water and then take some yellow and dab it at the center. I make very small dabs here because since there's already water there, it will spread the color evenly. Let me just push it around a bit so that it's a little faster. Okay, let's move on to the next flower. For this, I want it to be a little darker in color. So maybe I'll add purple to this. So as we did earlier, I'm just wetting that region with clean water. And let me mix my purple here. I'm just taking this rose color that I have along with some ultramarine to get a purplish color. And while the paper, especially that flower, is still wet, I make gentle dabs of this color there. You can see I've left a lot of white spaces within the flower. This is so that the whole flower is not just one tone of color. And here I'm just wiping my brush clean and then just gently pulling the color throughout the flower so that there are variations in the tone within the same flower. Now to make this a little darker, I think it's too light. Maybe we'll take a little bit more of the color, and as we did earlier, we just add little dabs in some corners of the flower and then we blend it in again. So just push it around with a moist brush. And you can see that you can find so many tones of purple within that flower by just using the same color. Here I'm adding a little bit of the pink at the center and just gently dabbing it off so that I don't want it to be too dark. Just wipe it off. Let me quickly add some yellow and a little bit of orange to the other smaller flowers. Once we're done with the berries, we can start adding the greens. You'll see in a bit that the green adds so much life to these flowers. They actually make the other colors pop. And so adding the right green is very important. And I want this green to be very natural looking. So I'm using sap green and I've mixed a little bit of red to it to give it a little brownish tinge. I feel the green is not enough in this, so I'm going to just extend this part which is already curved, and I'm just going to make similar leaves, similar curved and pointy leaves, so that I can add more green into the painting. Now while this green is still wet, I'm going to add a little bit of a darker shade of green at the tips of it So since it is still wet, it blends easily with it, as you can see here. And this again gives different tones within the leaf, which makes it look more natural. Maybe I'll add slightly bigger ones here, just pressing the brush and pulling it gently to create the leaf. The leaves need not be very perfect or anything. They just need to be a little bendy and curvy. And the brush helps us do it very easily. You just have to press it and pull it up quickly and you get a leaf instantly. Let me add little red highlights on these yellow flowers. It was looking a little bland, right? And let me blend it in a bit so that it's not too dominant. And that's it, we're done. Okay, wait, maybe I can add some more color here. I don't know if it's a good decision, but let's try it. I'll add some water over the lettering here and then add some color to that. So I'm adding an even layer of water. First, making sure the paper there is evenly wet. I'll take the same colors that we used earlier. Maybe I'll start with the purplish pink first. And then I can add the reddish color as well. You can see how the colors gently move when the paper is still wet. And that's the magic of watercolors. You can make bold, crisp lines, but you can also make these gentle, soft looking blends by just wetting the paper first and then adding the color. Let me make it a little yellowish, orangish on the left side. And yeah, I think this is enough for this, right? So that's it. We're done. And let me just take off the masking tape here. And our pretty little watercolor floral card is ready. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you do try it, please share it with us.